Good morning, good life. Welcome back to Amy TV, where we come together to help you go after the life you want. And this is another episode of the Freedom Five. Working from home continues to be the norm for many people, but it is difficult to figure out what it takes to get the swing of things from a productivity standpoint. The worst thing you can do is think that you have loads of time to get things done. And without a commute or useless chatter, that may feel like the case. But this is actually a little bit of a dangerous trap because you might forget to check out of work altogether and live your life. What I've learned is that anything that can help you be more focused and effective is what's actually going to get you to find any potential of balance while working from home. So in today's Freedom Five, I want to share five essential items in my home office that help me to achieve just that. The first item on my list is also the sponsor of this episode of Amy TV, and that is my HP OfficeJet Pro 8035 all-in-one printer. Even in the digital revolution, even with most of my business taking place on the internet, as a business owner, it's very important for me to have a printer in my office to help me with my work. Administrative tasks in business are just a fact of life, but they are a huge annoyance for me. So anything that I can use to help me get them done quicker and more efficiently is vitally important. This is why my printer is on the list. The OfficeJet Pro 8035 allows me to get things done in half the time with increased printer speeds. And this particular printer has self-healing Wi-Fi, so if there's any connectivity issues, it just resolves them itself. I also tend to print a lot of things out because I'm not the strongest digital reader. So if I have a really lengthy email, pro tip, don't send me a lengthy email if you would like me to reply faster. Or if there's like a contract or something that takes me a long time to figure out, I'll print it out, I'll read it a little bit more closely, highlight, take notes. It's just a lot better for me from a comprehension standpoint. One of my biggest pet peeves with printers in the past, and the reason that I stick with HP, is that setting up the printer from the beginning needs to be easy. I have actually gotten printers in the past that I couldn't set up and I basically just wanted to throw it in the trash. I didn't even want to take it back to the store because I was so annoyed with the fact that I unboxed it, plugged it in, and couldn't figure out how it worked. That's not the case with the OfficeJet Pro 8035. I plugged it in, I connected it to Wi-Fi, and it was printing within minutes for me. This is so important. Us small businesses, we don't have an IT department to do this for us. So yeah, get going with your only job, please. You can also print, scan, share, and copy files directly from your phone with the HP Smart app, which uses resources like Dropbox, Google Drive, the cloud, email, anything that really makes sense for your business. And I also love that the app allows me to let my assistant connect to my printer, so she can actually send things to my printer that I need to do, which is just like very efficient for me. I don't even have to think. I just take it, I sign, and I get it off to them. And by the way, that silly problem of running out of ink, don't worry about it. The HP OfficeJet Pro 8035 all-in-one comes with 8 months of free ink delivered to your door and even recognizes when it's low on ink to automatically ship it out to you. And with Instant Ink, high-resolution color prints and black and white text documents all cost the same. So printing in high-quality color actually saves you more. Shop now with the link in the description below so you can check out the HP OfficeJet Pro 8035 all-in-one printer. You will love it, especially because it's going to totally match your copy of Log Like a Boss, which I think is a bonus. I don't know about you. My second essential home office item is the Bose QuietComfort 35-2 wireless Bluetooth headphones. My husband and I have been sharing our loft a lot more with both of us working from home, and that is actually kind of nice because it's like having a coworker, but we don't have a door that we can shut, and some of us need a little bit of quiet every now and again. Whether I'm recording podcasts or he's taking phone calls, just being able to shut the other person out as needed is really important for focus in the office. Whenever he takes a call, I will put these headphones on and they are so fantastic at blocking out all sound. So if I'm writing or if I'm trying to return emails, I can stay focused without having to hear all the extra stuff that's going on or feeling like I have to leave in order to get that quiet time. I honestly only ever used to use these headphones on the airplane to listen to audiobooks and to protect my ears from the sounds of the airplane. But now without any travel, these headphones are just protecting me from getting too distracted at work, which I am all about. Probably the most impressive feature of the headphones themselves is the battery life. I feel like I never have to charge them and they last forever, which is great. But the hidden gem is how these headphones look on your head. and how they indicate, I cannot hear what you're saying. So if anyone is looking at you and you're wearing these headphones, it is the strongest indication that you need to be left alone. I mean, like, what could be better than that? I think having the conversation can be a little confrontational. Hey, I'm busy, I can't talk. But you put these headphones on, people don't tend to question that. You look busy with those things on. You look focused, at least. I don't think that there's a better do not disturb sign that you could have in the home office than these headphones sitting on your head. I will leave an Amazon affiliate link in the description for you to check these out for yourself. Number three on my list is my Peloton bike. I know this is a random one, but you gotta hear me out. There is nothing that refocuses me better than doing a workout. Trust me, I hate to say that. I don't like working out, but I can always tell when I'm in a rut or when I'm feeling more depressed or mellow or just not efficient, that it's because I have not been moving my body as much as I should be. My biggest issue with this is I don't know what to do for a workout or what I should do to actually stress my body in the positive ways that working out does. So having this Peloton at my house has been amazing because the instructors tell you what to do, which I really do need to be told what to do. And there are so many different options of classes that you can take. Having this bike in the house means no commuting, no small talking class, no extra time having to get ready to leave or get ready when you come home. It's just compounding how much a 30 to 45 minute class is actually 3 to 4 times that when you actually do it. I just don't have that kind of time. But I know right now I could go downstairs, change my clothes, hop on the bike, take a 20 minute spin class, and then take another 10 minute like arms class, because the bike comes with weights and everything, and do that and be done in 30 minutes, take a quick shower and come back to work. I mean, we're talking about less than an hour's time versus what it would actually take to go to a class someplace else. If I don't feel like using the bike, I can take a yoga class, I can do something else. The whole Peloton community has been so helpful for me in working from home and being able to work out at the times that I want to, that are going to get me back into a more efficient state of mind as quickly as possible. Number four on my essentials list for my home office is the bullet journal. When it comes to non-digital note-taking, I absolutely need this thing with me all the time. It is where I brain dump any ideas I have, any tasks I need to do, and get them on paper right away. I have this really bad habit if I'm working on the computer and I come up with an idea for something I need to do or something I want to research, I will open a new browser tab. Like this video if you can relate, because I know you can. I will open a new browser tab, type it into Google real quick, and then leave it there and go back to the thing I was doing. But the problem with that is you end up with all these browser tabs and you have such distraction in front of you that you decide to like start traveling into them even though you're working on another task right now. It's not efficient. So having my bullet journal open to collect all those things on paper rather than opening a world of distraction is so important and why I tend to use it very regularly on a day-to-day basis. I actually find if I'm not carrying it around with me throughout the house, I will miss it the moment it's gone. I'll think, I need to order that, I need to buy that, I need to do that. And if my bullet journal isn't right there, I worry about pulling out my phone to write it down in some app somewhere because I will forget and I will start checking TikTok. I just will. The other great thing about bullet journaling is just the migration technique month over month. So I will link to bullet journal videos that I've done in the past to explain this in more detail, but it's great for keeping track of your tasks over a longer period of time, not just through the day to day. And number five on my list is the Miracle Time Cube kitchen timers. I've mentioned these guys so many times. They sit on my desk, they're with me all the time because I cannot trust the timer on my phone. I will get too distracted. But these kitchen timers are fantastic for keeping me on task. If I say I'm only gonna take 20 minutes to get my emails done, I will turn that cube on and I will only spend 20 minutes on that task. And using these little, you know, archaic technology timers is a great way to stay focused because that little buzzer goes off and it makes you want to stop everything you're doing. I specifically love pulling out the timer that's got like only 60 seconds. If Vin wants to come talk to me and he's like, hey, I want to talk to you about something, I'll just like turn the timer on and be like, go ahead, you got 60 seconds. Because I'm busy. Didn't you see my headphones? Question of the day, what is your essential work from home item? I want to shop, so leave that in the comments below so that I can see what you need to stay efficient at home. Thanks again to the HP OfficeJet Pro 8035 all-in-one printer for sponsoring this episode of the Freedom 5. I hope you guys will check that out because I can't live without it. It is quite a productivity hub. And so you'll definitely want to check the link in the description for more information on that. That's all for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. I appreciate it. As always, make sure you subscribe for good vibes. Kiss the ones you love. and go after the life you want. Cheers. I'm late for a call now. Gotta go. Shoot.
Hello.
Hey, Alexa. Do not disturb for an hour.
I won't disturb you.
I don't think that's believable. I don't even know why I'm going on this tangent. I need to do that again. Ugh. And it's always in the hundreds. What's higher than 180? Not much. Come on. What? Sorry, I looked away for that last one, but I gotta go.